that I believe the Bible says, oh, the depth of the riches of the wisdom and the knowledge of God, how unchangeable, is judgment, and is past beyond praising out. Who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor? Who has ever given to God what God should repay? For from him and through him and for him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. Chapter 12, verse 1 and 7. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the view of God's mercy, to offer yourself as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Now, I want you to dwell in chapter 11, that I read downwards, but my key one is 12, verse 1, which talks about, therefore, I urge you. I want you to think about why Paul is inviting the church and telling them, therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the view of God's mercy. What he is saying is that there has been some things up there that he has spoken about God. He speaks about how unchangeable his judgments are. He talks about the depth of his riches. He talks about the wisdom and knowledge that God has. He talks about all this. He talks about how God is able not even to be given anything. He has everything. He says, who has given God wisdom? Who has been the counselor of God? Who has ever given God that he should repay them? You see, that is what tells you why he talks about this. Then in verse 6 he says, for from him and through him and for him are all things. He is completed in that statement. He is the source of everything that exists. And that's why the Bible says, because of this, you know, the one there is speaking of those things up there. And he says, because of all those things, or therefore, now, this is after you have heard, that after you have known, that after you have comprehended what God is, then he says, therefore, I urge you. The word urge means seriously requesting you. He is kind of telling you, giving you a request, a very humble request. He says, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the view of God's mercy. You are to know that it is by mercy that you exist and you have your being. You have everything that God has granted unto you. That's why he says, offer your bodies as living sacrifices. After you have known that the mercies of God are the ones that are sustaining you, then you have to surrender, dedicate yourself unto God as you offer yourself. Offering here does not mean you take yourself to the basket and give yourself as an offering. He is saying, surrender every bit of you that it may be useful in the kingdom of God. Just use the body that God has given unto you as a sacrifice. Somebody must know that before, you know, those that have maybe tasted the life, the two kinds of life, the two kinds of life. I have tasted it. I have tasted the life before somebody is born again, and I have tasted the life after being born again. Some have not tasted the latter. Maybe they were born in a church, or is it the former? The former or the latter? The former. They may have not tasted the former. What I mean by this is this, that you should decide, you should know that when Paul is saying like this, he is adding you to be a committed person somewhere. Lazima uwewe unahusika. Lazima ujitolee somewhere. Lazima mwili wako, maisha yako, yamtumikie Mungu katika jina la Yesu. Sema amen. Kwa hivyo, lazima you offer. And now, this one is also important. It is not God who is going to offer you by force. No, you are the one who is doing it. Ni wewe mwenyewe unajipeana. Na hivi muhimu kuelewa ya kwamba anything that God will use in your life, any part of your life that God can use, it's only dependent on your offering. Ni wewe, hakuna mtu mwingine. Ukiamua macho yako itumikie Mungu, inamtumikia. Ukiamua akili zako zitumikie Mungu, zinamtumikia. Ukiamua mikono yako itumikie Mungu, inamtumikia. Ukiamua hivi kweli, hakuna kitu hata moja ungetamani kifanya hiyo asitafanya. That is very important, that you are the only person who is key in the offering. That's why the Bible says, offer yourself with that knowledge. That's how we can knowledge. That's how we can farm. Ya kwamba Mungu ndiye mwenye kila kitu. Ili ukijipeana kwake, unajipeana kwa Mungu kama huyo. May God bless you. Very good. Ingekuwa hapa sasa.